Good morning, Matt. Lovely weather we've got out here today. So what we're going to do is have a look at Carolina's technique, especially as she's just come back from surgery.
Okay.
So we'll get some force data on the water and see how she's looking.
Yeah, that's great.
Gotta love these early morning starts. Everything's set up. Hopefully the measuring equipment will give some ideas as to areas the rower can improve on. Now we can analyse the rower's power distribution. She could be using her arms more evenly, especially towards the end of her row. This information doesn't lie. Some of the things that did come up from Carolina's test was there was a bit of difference between the right and the left side. So maybe that's something that we can work on in the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, certainly. We'll look at that in training and get back to you in a couple of weeks.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good morning, Jade.
How are you?
Oh, very good, thank you. I've always had a passion for sport, so I studied sports science at university and decided to specialise in biomechanics. I also worked for a year in the Australian Institute of Sport, helping another biomechanist and learning how to operate within a sports institute environment. A knowledge of audio-visual equipment, electronics and computer programming skills also comes in handy. Looks like our equipment needs a service. Water and electronics just don't mix. Time to catch up on what else is happening in the world of biomechanics. The research of others can give me a foundation for developing my own tests. There's not much point in replicating information and strategies that have already been developed. We'll have a look at some of the factors like her velocity, both horizontal and conversion into vertical velocity.
Perfect.
At the actual point of takeoff.
We'll try to filming you from two cameras, two different angles, to find critical spot of beginning of curve. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
Excellent.
There should be an easier way of recording this information and getting the results to the athlete sooner. They need immediate feedback on their consistency.
That's too much. You are in dead position. And you're really flying with the bar.
I have to map this footage frame by frame. The animation, combined with an understanding of human anatomy and the laws of mechanics, gives me details about the potential and kinetic energy of this athlete based on the movement of their center of gravity. Morning, Marty. How are you today?
Good morning, Andrew. Very well.
Great. We've been doing some high jumping testing lately, and I've got this great new idea for a way to measure the approach of the high jumpers so we can look at their consistency.
Okay. Look, if you want to put something down on paper and get it to me, it's a few facts and figures and how much you think that'll cost, whether you've got the coaches on side with all of this. Get that to me as soon as possible. We'll have a look at it and see if we can get it working.
It's good to get out of the office occasionally. Must remember to book tickets over east for that track championship. Try and maximise some of the conversion from the horizontal to the vertical velocity throughout the last phase of tracking off.
You must be faster, and as your faster angle is, of course, smaller for elevation.
This job is all about initiative, pushing the boundaries of testing and looking at areas of performance that haven't been assessed by anyone else. Some tests don't work, but when they do, it's really exciting to give our athletes that extra edge over their competitors.